Hello dear friends, in my previous video we were discussing on module number 6B, Gateman's Gift by R.K. Narayan. Almost half extract is already covered. We have seen or discussed line by line. Today we are going to discuss on remaining part of the extract. The assembly looked up for their pages and watched him with mild amusement in their eyes. The assistant kindly put his arms on his shoulder and led him out. "You get well first and then come back. I tell you, you are not all right." His rejection to open the registered postal letter and eagerness to knowing what exactly in that letter without opening it creates an amusement for the people who are sitting there and reading journals. The assistant kindly request him to go to your home and get well soon. And then we will discuss about the issue. Walking back home, he pondered over it. Why are they all behaving like this, as if I were a madman? He was just thinking while going to home that why are they all behaving like this, as if I am a madman? When this word came to his mind, he stopped abruptly in the middle of the road and cried, "Oh, that's it. Is that it? Mad, mad." He shook his head gleefully as if the full truth had just dawned upon him. He now understood the looks of the people threw at him. He reminded their looking towards him. Now really he came to know what exactly happened there. People were thinking that I am a mad person. "Oh," he cried aloud. He felt a curious relief at his realization. "I have been mad and didn't know." He cast his mind back. Every little attention of his for the last so many days seemed mad. He observed his personal activities he'd done in last few days that seemed him mad activities, particularly the doll making. What sane man would make clay dolls after 25 years of a respectable service in an office? He has not seen any person after 25 years of his reputed service that he started to make a dolls from a clay. He felt tremendous freedom of limbs and did not feel it possible to walk at an ordinary pace. He was terribly disturbed. He became unhappy. And to put a single pace with his limbs makes impossible. He wanted to fly. He swung up his arms up and down and ran on with the hoof, just like a mad person. He thrown his two hands in the air and started to run as if he is flying in the air. He ran through the market road. When people stood about and watched, he cried, Hey, don't laugh at a madman, for who knows, you will also be mad when you come to make clay dolls. People were curiously seeing towards him, and he was telling people, all the people, that don't look at me. You will be mad if you try to create small dolls from the clay. And all this happened in the market road, where a lot of people were there and charged into their midst with a war cry. When he saw children coming out of a school, he felt it would be nice to amuse their young hearts by behaving like a tiger. He saw some students were coming out of the school, and he thought that he would go there and amuse these students by behaving like a tiger. So he fell on his hands and knees and crawled up to them with a growl. He started to crawl, put his hands and knees down on the earth and started to crawl while making a growl. He went home in a terrifying condition. After doing all these things, he tired too much. Finally, he went to his home in a terrible condition, terrifying condition. His wife, who was grinding chili in the backyard, looked up and asked. His wife was there. What she was doing? She was grinding chili in the backyard, looked towards him and asked, "What is this?" His hair was covered with street dust. It is totally dirty with dust. His body was splashed with mud. Mud was around his body. He could not answer because he choked with mirth as he said, "Fancy, what has happened? What is it?" His wife once again asked. He could not answer because of extreme happiness. He replied, "I am mad, mad." He looked at his work basket in a corner, scooped out the clay, and made a helmet of it and put it on his head. He went to a basket putting in the corner. In that basket there was a clay. He took out all the clay, made a helmet of that clay, and put this helmet on his head. Arranged on the floor was his latest handiwork. After his last visit to the office, he had been engaged in making a model village. After his last visit to his office for the pension, he was starting to create a model village of the clay. It was a resplendent group. A very bright group it was. A dun road, that is grey colored road, red tiles, green coconut trees swaying, and the color of the saris of the village women carrying water pots. So all kinds of atmosphere he created with the help of that clay. So very nice work he had done. He derived the inspiration for it from the memory of his own village days. He remembered his childhood days and village where he lived, and he tried to decorate all these scenes with the help of these clays. It was the most enjoyable piece of work that he had so far undertaken. Most enjoyable work. He lived in a kind of ecstasy while doing it. Whole the day he was full of enthusiasm and trying to create a new atmosphere, new design, new work. I am going to keep this for myself. He already decided that whatever he was doing, he will keep for himself. A memento of my father's village. He recognized his creation as the memento of his father's village. He declared, "I will show it at an exhibition where they will give me a medal. There is an expectation of his beautiful work that he will get a medal if he put all this into exhibition. He guarded it like a treasure. When it was wet, he never allowed his wife to walk within 10 yards of it. Keep off. We don't want your foot dust for this village." He even did not allow his wife to enter in that premises so that the beautiful picture will not be disturbed by his wife. So beautifully, so enthusiastically, so delicately he created the village with the clay. It was a great contribution and it was his masterpiece also. So we will discuss the remaining part of the story in my next video. Thank you.